Hello everybody and welcome to yet another unsufferable Laserdisc episode of One Credit Champ. And you know what? I don't know how many more of these I can handle, so enjoy them while you can. The only question now is, what are we playing today? Bally Midway presents today's game, and it's called Galaxy Ranger. It's another fucking Sega one. Oh my god, no. Let's put the credit in. Let's press start. Let's do this. As you can tell, this game is very, very, very similar to Astron Belt, aside from the sprite. Could be the same fucking game, really. It's got different footage, but the mechanics are the same. We've got a 60-second timer. We're invincible for that amount of time, and then we get a couple of lives, and then we've just got to survive on our own. As with the last game, half of the explosions don't seem to have any cause. That one did. I did shoot that plane. Yeah, there we go. And that one. Well, that's a bonus. Oh my god, look at this awesome little model runway they've built for this game. Oh dear. No expense was spared. Or indeed spent during the production of this. Oh, God. I mean, look at that. They couldn't be bothered to put an explosion in the right position on the screen when I hit that ship. That one works. That one works. That was in the right place. Oh, my God. Extended play. We're onto lives now. No invincibility for us. And Jesus Christ, are these ships going at quite a rate. And I have absolutely no idea if they can crash into me or not. So I'm just going to keep on moving and stay out of the way. You know, I didn't think that Sega could make a more confusing Laserdisc game than Astron Belt, but they quite obviously did, didn't they? You know what, that shouldn't have happened, surely. That scene skip there. Maybe it's an emulation problem. I mean, it's not like I can go into an arcade, play an original Astron Belt or Galaxy Ranger cabinet, and record my experiences of that, is it? I mean, they're probably very rare by now, and all the Laserdiscs are rotted away. You know, so I have to make do. I have to make do with emulation for these things. And this makes no sense. Half of this stuff makes no sense. And it's sped up as well. I don't know if it's supposed to speed up. It probably is to, you know, make it more difficult. But it's just all so confusing. It's random scene after random scene. There doesn't seem to be any context. And I think there's supposed to be a boss at the end of the game as well. There was in Astron Belt. It was one of the ships from Wrath of Khan turned upside down. I'm not even joking there. And you know, I said I didn't know if Sega had the license for that video or not. Apparently they did, because at the time Sega were owned by Gulf and Western, who owned Paramount Pictures. So that's how they got away with using the Star Trek footage. Surprised that they didn't credit it in any way, though. I mean, Toei got a credit. Apparently, the footage from that comes from some 1978... What the fuck happened then? The game just ended! What the fuck happened then? No, I didn't get to the end of the game. I'm sure I didn't get to the end of the game. That just fucking ended! Crying out loud. Oh, well. Name in. Bum. As usual. You now have the option to continue from the last scene, so I didn't finish the game then. Obviously. You just booted me out. I didn't even die. You know, I'm tempted to put the credit in to find out, but I can't because it's against the rules. So I'm just left here. Confused. Forever. Oh well, until next time. Bye.
Hello everybody, I am here to bring you a special announcement. Due to the fact that YouTube ad revenue nets me sweet dick all money, and the fact that apparently you can get Patreon pledges purely to make podcasts about arses in video games now, I thought I would set up my very own begging page. The link is down here, www.patreon.com/Mentski, and any money pledged to me will be used to improve the channel in any way I see fit.
I promise, I won't spend it all on drink and drugs.
So if you think this channel has any kind of value whatsoever and you want to help me improve it, go over to the website, drop a couple of pence in. I mean, what's the worst that can happen? I end up spending all the money on something frivolous? Do I look like the type of person that would do that? Really. Until next time, cheery bye-bye, Peen. Not sure what the hell's going on with that hand.